a messenger is told to report all that has happened, informing the people that Beowulf is dead. He goes on to tell of the wars that he foresees with the Franks and the Frisians, as well as the Swedes, avenging the killing of King Angentheow at Ravenswood. He retells the story of Ravenswood. Angentheow had cornered the Geats' army, and Higelac came to their rescue. He forced Angentheow to withdraw and fight for his life. He was eventually killed by Iuvair of the Geats. Now that Beowulf is dead, Angentheow's people will seek revenge. The men go to the cliff and find the bodies of Beowulf and the dragon. Wiglaf tells of the king's courageous fights, although he questions the decision to fight alone. He takes 7 chiefs, removes the treasure, and builds a tall funeral pyre in Beowulf's honor. He ponders Beowulf's fate. The poet recounts the grief of the people as a woman sings of sadness and doom at Beowulf's funeral. Wiglaf is a natural leader, but even he is worried what Beowulf's death might mean for the Geats. The messenger predicts that the chaos that will ensue may include invasions and more attacks by creatures. This gives readers the impression that Beowulf was a powerful leader who made friends with the right people. His death further enforces the theme of death and defeat. There is a lot of talk about the gold, and the people decide it is best to burn it with Beowulf's body. Beowulf sought fame, but from a place of loyalty, honor, and responsibility. Like any other man, however, he was human and made mistakes, such as not leaving an heir in place. Nonetheless, he was undoubtedly a true hero.